Good morning, everyone. I'm headed to Manly Beach today. I'm walking to Circular Quay. I'm meeting my friend over there, and we're gonna have some breakfast at Novotel. I don't know why she wants to have it at Novotel, but we're gonna have breakfast there. And it's just a beautiful morning. It's gonna be 34 degrees today though, so perfect time to hit the beach, hence the beach outfit. And this is Pyrmont Bridge for you guys. It's pretty quiet Saturday morning so far. It's only 7 a.m. so kind of probably the reason why. I just love how the sun is reflected on the buildings. I mean, the video isn't doing it justice. And I know that the sun is coming out from the other side. You can tell from how it shines through that side. But it's just, and when it's quiet like this here in Pyrmont, it's just so much better. Actually, the plan was for me to cycle to Circular Quay and then take the ferry from there. But we are going to be hitting some op shops later. So I didn't think it was a good idea for me to have my bicycle with me. And also, like I mentioned, it's gonna be about 34 degrees today. So it's not really a good idea to be cycling. We're just gonna hang out at the beach after we do some op shopping. Harbour Bridge and the Sydney Opera House. It was the sun run, and I was supposed to run this one, but I didn't register. I did it last year, so that's why there's all of these people with their finisher medals and numbers. So Pinky and I are meeting at the Novotel. We're gonna have breakfast there. She wants to have breakfast there. Apparently she's treating me for my birthday that passed. So, yeah, I'll show you what their breakfast looks like. There's also a weekend market here that we might end up checking out after breakfast, but definitely op shopping is our priority today. That's the whole reason why I went all the way here to Manly in the first place. But just go straight up here, all the way there. Definitely getting some of those. Lifeline, which is an op shop here in Manly, right at the center of it. And we were quite disappointed with the pricing. It's so expensive that there are items that you could already buy brand new when it's on sale. So I didn't even like bother taking time to look through the racks, because even if I find something that I like, I'm not gonna buy it because it's just so expensive. Right, Pinky?
Yes.
Okay, so now we're at the Red Cross shop here, also on Manly, and we'll see what we can find here. Ano lang? Wipe lang. And now we're here at Vinny's. This is our third stop. looks promising. We'll see. So we've been to 3 op shops so far, and I haven't bought anything. Not that I hadn't found anything that I like, but it wasn't in my list of needs or on my wish list, so I left it behind. Now we're gonna go to another town and see if it'll be more fruitful over there. So we arrived at the Salvo stores here in Mona Vale. Yes, Mona Vale. Like, it was a really far place to go to. But yeah, we're here. Oh, well, this isn't Salvo's yet, but apparently the one here is quite big, so we'll see. 100% all shoes. Sounds promising. This skirt was nice, but it's too small for me. I was almost going to get these. They've never been worn, their samples, but discovered that it had that sort of like ink stain on it. I don't know if I can take it off. Okay, this is our second Lifeline that we're going to, but this is in Mona Vale. It's a little bit smaller than the one that we went to, but let's see what they've got. Oh, a $5 rack. Let's go. Trying to beat the heat with mango smoothies. We found another Lifeline on the way. This wasn't our plan, but since we're here, we might as well. So we're at the outlet of Ozzale, and it's really overwhelming. We already went inside. I didn't buy anything because, for one thing, I didn't want to buy anything new. And for another, I was like really overwhelmed with the choices. They're like, it's all of the things that have probably been returned from Ozzale. That's an online marketplace in Australia, and they're like, they sell their stuff for cheap. So they've got this outlet here, and I don't know, I just don't feel like buying anything new when there are so many secondhand choices around. So I fell asleep on the bus, by the time I got to Neutral Bay earlier, the bus was stopped right in front of Lifeline, so I actually got off there and went to 3 other places. So there was Lifeline, Red Cross, and what was the other one? Recycled Rags, but didn't buy anything from there, and now I'm headed to the last 2 places. So this is the Vinnie's here on Oxford Street in Darlinghurst. It's a little bit funny when you see the shoes that you donated being resold. Yeah, these 2 are from me. What's even worse is I want to buy them again. So I didn't get anything from there, as expected, but I did really want to find new pumps. Still haven't found the perfect one, but it's okay, I can wait. Last place is U-Turn Vintage. So there was a Celine bag in U-Turn Vintage, and ordinarily I would have jumped at the chance to buy that, especially since I saw that there was a authenticity card inside, but the style of the bag isn't very practical for me, and I don't even know if it's real because My replicas have authenticity cards too. So it's very easy to fake the authenticity card. So yeah, I didn't buy anything from there either. Very proud of myself, actually. Now it's time for me to go home because I am exhausted. Like, my legs are dying. Okay, so this is the 12th op shop. I didn't realize that there was a new op shop right here. Okay, so I just came out of the Red Cross op shop, but I didn't end up getting anything. There wasn't really anything that struck me as nice. And I think I'm just too tired to actually go through all the racks. So I'm heading home now with my KFC. Actually, come to think of it, that Celine bag. I've seen one of those before in better condition, but a smaller one, and they were selling it $175 before, and I got it for a friend of mine. This particular one didn't seem like it was the real deal. It was $99 though, which is usually how they price their authentic stuff, so I don't know. Okay, so this is what I ended up getting after going to 12 different shops. This leather belt, Salvo Stores, $10. And it's like really nice leather. Obviously quite worn out, but I like the rugged feel of it. So I got that. And then these two, well, it's actually just one. It's one pair of Diana Ferrari leather shoes. Now, it doesn't look like it's been used. That water is from the Pepsi Max. There's a little bit of scuffing there and there, but if you look at the bottom, it looks pristine. Like, it might have been because of the storage that it looked like that. Like, it looked like something hard fell on it. That's why. But you can see it says there, leather upper, non-leather lining, and sole made in China. And that is quite a unique feature. I don't know why they have it. But yeah. This was $15 originally, but their shoes were all 20% off, so I ended up having this for $12, which is almost the same price as the belt. But I thought maybe one different colored pair of shoes would be nice. I want to work on that scuffing, see if I can fix it. Yep. Okay, so I am finally home, and I am so freaking tired. It's so hot. I'm just going to rest for a little bit before I take a shower so that my muscles aren't going to freak out. But yeah, I'm so tired. I'll see you all again in the next video. And I hope you enjoy this one. Let me know in the comment section down below. $22 after 12 op shops. I think that's not bad.